hear our voice together as one in reverence. We call on thee within the end.
As the midnight moon rises on black wings, we await the light at the end. In life and in death, glory to Mother Miranda.
Hey, remember me? I almost died up at that castle. Tell me, what is going on around here?
How can a man be almost dead? That's a question for the wise.
You know what I mean. And I still haven't found Rose. Where did Mother Miranda take her?
You're too late. Or maybe almost too late. The child will be sacrificed, life for life.
What kind of sick medieval shit is this? She's just a baby.
The crests of the four bloodlines may open the path you seek.
Will you please stop talking in riddles? I just want to find my daughter.
It's only a riddle if you don't know the answer.
Wait a second. That looks familiar. Hey, hey, wait!
There you are. I had a feeling you...
Welcome, Ethan. Bits and bobs? I see. Oh, Lady Dimitrescu. Beautiful even in death. That waistline, yes.
Damn it. Better see the Duke again.
How was it? Did you learn anything?
I found these feathers. Now tell me how to fix this like you said you would.
Settle down. First, you must use that key and collect all of your little roses flasks.
Where are the rest of them?
There are four in total. You have the one, and the other lords have the rest.
Lords?
Mother Miranda is the cold, calculating ruler of this village. Four lords serve under her. The first you've already met, the Lady Demetresque. The second lives deep in a valley of mist, the dollmaker, Donna Beneviento. None of her playmates have ever come back from that dank old estate. The third is Moreau, a being of twisted flesh that lives in the reservoir past the windmills. It is said that he is not the only monster that lives in those waters. The fourth and most dangerous is Heisenberg. He works in his factory on the village outskirts. And the project, let's just say parts of the human imagination are better left alone. If you truly wish to save your daughter, you must first gather the four flasks. I'll do you a personal favor. I've marked the Lord's locations on your map. Some treasures still lurk in this village. I'm sure each one will prove of great use to you.
Why are you doing all this?
Why, it's all part of our first-class customer service. Please do come again soon.
Ethan.
What?
Ethan, come with me. There's something I have to tell you.
Mia? What's going on?
Rose feels different. Ethan. You have to fix her.
What the hell is this?
Everyone leaves me. Even Rose. I don't want to be alone.
This can't be real. Am I losing it? What's going on?
so long. I'd make a much better daughter than Rose. Please, won't you stay with me forever?
What?
Wait, where's my gun?
We know these game developers and publishers are so anxious to work with kids move respectfully.
I agree with Smoot, but my own opinion on this is this. I had a classroom. It was a some kind of like insurance act, some bullshit class. I was like health insurance, whatever. And the top people feel about
it. Yeah, exactly. That's the thing. Like, you know, this is a very sensitive issue, and you're part of a like a big company. Like, just keep your mouth shut. Against the grain on this one, like, why take the risk?
So do you see how messed up it is that you're allowed?
It is absolutely that you're allowed
to keep your job if you're, and it's not like he was even being hateful or anything. He was just like, this is where I stand, this is where what it is. But people are saying, oh, this guy hates women, he must be this, he must be that, da 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 da. I don't know, it's like he just doesn't support the killing of babies. I don't know why we're trying to make it seem like he's the devil or something. I thought he was extremely disrespectful. So, we were getting people like Corey Barlow. I will never be buying another God of War game. Yeah. That's exactly what I said. I have no comment. Whether you agree with me or disagree with me, I will not share my thoughts and feelings.
And a lot of peers have the nerve. After her little racist thing, then she ran her ass off to Australia and that's a trap there. And then when something comes up that can't heat off her, she'll be the first one talking. I don't like soft people like that. Like that cowardice of like, you know, I got dirt, but I'm gonna hide my dirt and bring up your dirt.
That you tweet out something, every time that you talk, your job is on the line every single time. No matter if it's pro something.
Why is the CEO even tweeting about this crap?
I don't know.
Yeah, he said like a lot of his gaming people are talking about it, so if he's talking, just throw his hat into the ring and say where he stands. It wasn't smart.
And he only had 5,000 followers, so he didn't think it was probably gonna reach like that. All his little developer friends get away, they were able to talk freely about it because they were on the other side of the spectrum.
Yeah.
So they were able to freely talk freely about it. So, you know, all right, so this is the topic that we're talking about. His opinion was different. It was, let's declare war. Everybody's freaking out. I can't stand.
That was a virtual.
Why is this here?
Bond, but, no, I'm saying,
still his company.
he got one of the biggest patrons.
If we get too big, this podcast is respectful.
Yes, sir.
So yeah, Tales of Arise. Shadow Elite, I'm gonna let you take the reins on this one. So, I played Tales of Arise. I played about 45 minutes to an hour, and you know, I thought it was cool. And you know what's to hit for me, some of them haven't. Like, I bought Scarlet Nexus, and I'm like, you know, I ain't sure about this. Ended up loving it. I bought Tales of Arise. Yep. I'm like, man, I don't really want to fit. I don't know about this. So it's like sometimes you
really.
It's like I. Sometimes you know, but sometimes you don't know even when you sure. So yeah, like Scarlet Nexus was like I couldn't get enough of it, even though it became some, you know, fuckery towards the end with aliens and time travel and all this other shit. But yeah, that shit was fire to me. Tales of Arise is okay. It's not bad at all. You know, I don't know. It's just not connecting. But yeah, tell us about it, Shadowfall.
Shadowfall.
But yeah, Tales of Arise is great. It's got an 87 on Metacritic right now. It has over 60,000 concurrent players on Steam. It's doing really well. I'm enjoying the game a lot. Visually, it's really good. This is like the second best JRPG.
Access to about six. You have ground combos, like some of them can go into air combos that way. But you can unlock more as the game progresses. Since battle seems like a little bit limiting, so I'm hoping you're able to unlock the prompts to. There's been some. A lot of people are having trouble with the first and second boss. Kind of interesting. He was really tanky, but I was able to get through it. But I can definitely see why people are a little bit, you know, having trouble with it. I'm not sure how the rest of the arts and buffs behind the CP system. And if you have that luck for the most part when it comes to recovering, unless you got like some items to help you recover. And you run out of CP pretty fast. You want to recover it, but the orange gel, they cost way too much. You don't get that much money from regular. And you have DLC that allows you to just have money automatically. Like, and you also got experience pieces and whatnot that will help you, you know, gain more levels. I don't think that's right. But no, but no.
I thought people were exaggerating, but I'm starting to see as I play it more, it seems that they're trying to gear me towards getting the microtransactions, and I'm going to go as long as I can without doing it.
One of the things about the DLC is that there are certain costumes, and if you buy the DLC costumes, you unlock certain skills and arts and passives that you can unlock in-game, of course, if you choose to unlock them via the skill grid. That's terrible. You should not be locking arts and skills behind paywalls. I don't know what Bandai Namco is thinking on that one. That's pretty stupid.
They've been doing that for a while now.
Yeah, since the PS3 era.
Not unlocking skills. Not locking skills. They have never unlocked box skills or, you know, arts that you use in battle behind costumes. I've never seen that.
But you said Namco Bandai can still unlock these skills just playing the game.
No, you can't. No, the swimsuit DLC and stuff like that that have the skills, you can unlock those in game. You gotta buy that swimsuit.
Oh, you gotta buy it. Okay, I thought you said you can.
Yeah. Yeah. So it's a little bit questionable in that area. I'm gonna see if it's really egregious, because it seems that every boss is throwing people for a loop for the most part, and it doesn't seem that the difficulty is scaling enough. I'm thinking they want you to actually play the game well, like dodge, use combos, don't just rely on using items. I'm hoping that's the case, but we'll see. We'll see going
forward. Grind.
Yeah, grinding, you could grind, but that's the thing. You don't gain that much level, that much experience grinding. It's the same as money. You don't get that much money. Like, you know how usually you play a JRPG, you go through a dungeon, you beat a boss, the boss gives you extra, you know, experience, extra money. Next down, you will need to stock up with some items that you can buy, new weapons and armor. In this game, not so much. You can't do that. So far, I've been very limited on what I can do, and I have to make sure that I'm using certain my money wisely. Yeah, for the most part, yeah. You can't decide to sell that one, but they're also not giving us much.
Thank you.
mainstream games only.
I hate to see it.
And some indie games.
Somebody in the chat asks, they baby stepped into Nino Kuni as their, you know, first steps into JRPGs. Do you think they would be based on playing that?
Your first, second JR. Yes, I'd say yeah, you would like it.
You might want to play it on a lower difficulty. Like, yeah, it's so far it's a pretty tough game. You gotta know what you're doing, or else you're gonna have to. Yeah, you got normal, easy, moderate. I'm playing on moderate now. But so far, I wouldn't recommend putting it on hard on the game.
Circle. So these dudes got fired by the Sony. I assumed it was going to be VR, but I don't know. They didn't say anything about it.
Experiences,
yeah,
like full game type shit.
But you know, even though I haven't played any of their previous games,
I'm not hyped.
Ah!
You're still alive, huh? Before my friends murder you! T'Chak! Your life's alive.
Wait!
Try and find me. And King Thrash tweeted this out, because I don't follow this guy, I've heard him before, but pre-release, right? Now, the same temperature he said the new PS5 was running. But the Xbox had the same goddamn read, and it was cool. You see what I'm saying? So it's like, What's really the goal at the end of the day? Hey, man, y'all call it. I don't know.
Insane that they actually went through the trouble to do that.
Yeah. If this was like, you know, maybe PlayStation of the past.
I'm looking at this Austin Evans video, and it seems that he made a correction to the initial video, but he hasn't integrated.
I don't know about all that, but if he said it happened, sure, why not? This is my thing, though. He then goes on to describe how, yeah. For it and then come playing victim, bro. I don't like that shit. Like, you knew what you was doing. You knew what come with this type shit, yet you did it anyway. So what the fuck? You want me to feel bad for you, bro?
Listen, people do things for that YouTube algorithm, bro. It doesn't surprise me, like...
It's over. Mia, we'll make things right. What? Good. I need to get out of this place. So that's who was behind all this? That makes two.
Like, I don't like what people...